Hi everyone, it's Jim Davis here. I'm on Long Point Provincial Park, which is a peninsula of land that goes out into Lake Erie. I'm here photographing for the day. I was here last night with virtual photo walk, so I'm back again today to just kind of introduce everybody to the area. Weather has changed significantly, so as you can see, it's very gray and rainy here right now. But we're making the best of it. I can go ahead and flip the camera around just to show a quick view of what we're looking at. So this is a scene that is down the beach with a very large tree that is beached up on the shoreline here. So this would be the subject that we'll be working on today.
Who we have here? There's Bruce, our esteemed producer. This is Colin, otherwise why it's known as some guy who hangs around with Corey. This is Jim, who I've been on walks with before and always enjoyed them. This is, oh yeah, John for virtual photo walks, and the weird chick with the purple hair is Corey Fisk. I usually come along on these, and I would absolutely love to get a couple of pictures of that, of the washed up tree. It's a fascinating piece. If you would be so kind to be my eyes and my hands, and think you could, would you mind doing that for me, Garber? Because it is fantastic. Even in rain and overcast, it's just
absolutely gorgeous.
Lovely out here.
Yeah, absolutely.
So Jim, can you tell us a little bit about that area?
This is Lake Erie, which is located in southern Ontario.
Okay.
Yeah, it's one of the Great Lakes, and This peninsula that we're on right now is very significant in the respect that it's a UNESCO World Heritage Site and Wildlife Preserve. I'll just turn the camera around there. And what's significant about it is because it goes out into Lake Erie by 40 kilometers, a lot of the migrating birds will stop here on their flights over the lake. It's a resting place for them before they head farther north. So you get a very high number of different species, and it's up to about 380 different species of birds that come here during the spring and fall.
Can you leave the camera on the water so I can pretend I'm at the beach while you talk?
Yeah, I certainly can.
I enjoy looking at you.
I will turn the camera and I will walk down.
Let me look
right
at the water.
The edge of the water.
Yes, thank you. Just hearing the waves and looking at the water over the sand is, you know, every time I go someplace different on these walks and every time something in it I wasn't expecting hits me over the head and says, hey, you love this. And this I could have expected because this is the closest thing I will ever to see my home again.
John, do you have the map up there?
Yep.
Okay, so if you go out to the tip of Long Point, showing on the map, we will be taking his boat out there and staying overnight. And there's a lighthouse right at the tip of the point. So tell Corey this before I do all my night job. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put Daryl on, and he can just have a quick conversation with you, Corey, because I think you know Daryl.
Yeah, I believe so. I may not, but I will see him come to me.
Yeah. So we're going to be coming out, and we're going to be staying overnight and doing some night photography. So what we'll do is we'll get the tip of the peninsula with the lighthouse and hopefully with the Milky Way. This is one of the few places in southern Ontario that you would consider it to be a close to a dark sky area.
Oh, that's
so the stars will show up very nicely.
I'm jealous. I don't get to spend midnight with the men who are camping out under the stars. Mm-hmm. You'll have to take some good pictures for me.
I'll just show you just some of the different compositions that are possible here. With some of the trees
can you get that piece
up onto shore.
Board? The Yeah, that one. That chat right there.
Yeah,
Thank you.
I will get that.
Yeah. Oh, yes, please. Reading my mind, or do you just know what I like?
So normally what I'll do in a situation like this, if I find a subject that I find that's kind of appealing, is I'll take a look at it and I'll study it. And I'll say, okay, what kind of a composition can I come up with to maximize the subject that I have here? So I'll just,
Ooh, almost
yeah.
like it right here. Looks like a fisherman sort of out his line. Can you get that shot right there for me? I'd
Yeah,
appreciate
I
it.
will. There's all kinds, there's not a whole lot of shells here, but there are some. I'll see if I can find some.
Yeah. Oh, just the paw
Animal
prints.
prints.
Hang on. There's the shells right there. The look there, and there are those animal prints. Yeah, those.
Yep,
Think that's worth a
those are
shot?
actually dog prints.
Okay,
Oh, yeah.
dog prints. Good. Yeah, I think they may be worth a shot or two as well.
Some of the dune grasses. These grasses, they play a very important role in the fact that they, the root system gives the ground something to hold on to and the sand to hold on to, so that it helps reduce the erosion. And the little these are some ants that would not normally be up at this time of year, so they've been working on their little ant houses under the ground again. Just shows the little cluster of them there, which is kind of interesting. It's
I
always
think
nice
it's a good
to.
shot.
Yeah. So what I'm going to do is just to show you how much it's raining. I will turn the camera around again and show you just
Oh, I
a little
love
bit of
watching
water here and.
the
See if
Oh,
you can see
thank
the
you.
raindrops coming down.
Can I just see that for a little while? It's beautiful. If you hold it still, for a second, it gets very, very clear. Colin, what do you think? Colin? Oh, Colin thinks he's in the other room. Okay. Just like the figure walking down the beach right there. It puts everything into a rather sharp perspective. Thank you. It's always good spending time with you, Jim. Thank you for taking the time and joining us and
Actually like this
inviting us to join your virtual photo wall.
Well, thank you.
Thank you.
Yep, this is from the opposite end.
That was the first shot. Let's make it the closer.
Yep.
You open with it and close with it.
Here we go. I just wanted to say thank you to you, John, and to Corey, to give me the opportunity to bring this experience to you guys. It's a pleasure for me, and it's an honor for me as well.
It does give you a special feeling, doesn't it?
It certainly does.
Yeah,
Absolutely.
quite something. Spread the word and get lots more people to participate that we can help. And I'm telling everybody that's out there, there's somebody within 5 blocks of your house that we can help. So reach out and show them what Gmail is and what Google Hangouts is, and get someone involved in this.
Start with you later, baby.
Bye, Bruce. Bye, Corey.
Bye.
Bye, honey. Thank you for taking the time and joining us and
Actually like this
inviting us to join your virtual photo wall. It puts everything into a rather sharp perspective.